Hi there guys, my name is Steve, I'm your host, and this is a show where we talk only about games and gaming industry. I'm excited because last week I have been to Japan. It was a Tokyo Games Show, one of the best and most important events in Japan when we are talking about gaming industry. And I'm so thrilled to share with you what I have experienced in Japan and how amazing it is. So if you're looking from the business standpoint of view, Japanese market for the gaming, you can quickly learn from the revenue standpoint of view that having one Japanese player or a customer or user, however you define that, in your game is same like having two US-based or three European-based players. And the one Japanese player spends equivalent money to three from Europe. So if you're able to make a game that's successful in Japan, you potentially can make more revenue. Now, that's not the only thing when you're looking from the business standpoint of view, okay? Japan has been forefront of the entertainment for a very long time. The entire country, and if you have ever been to Japan, it's all like gamified, the entire country. You can see gamified ads, you can see many interacting things, many entertainments along the way, and basically everybody in Japan are playing some kind of game. Their biggest three IPs being Naruto, One Piece, Dragon Ball Z, all these old, very extremely valuable IPs for the games are even today extremely popular. I had a meeting with a guy who's running 200-300 people a game company, and they're all still playing all those games. And I'm gonna also tell you, Transformers are extremely popular in Japan. Power Rangers IP is extremely popular in Japan. You have a Digimon, Pokemon, extremely popular in Japan, and everybody are engaging with this IP, and many companies are trying to do something in Japan. The Japan is also a leader in Asia, and for that matter in the world, for trends in gaming. Many Western companies were studying Japanese games and Japanese models, how they engage, and they were taking, or I'm not gonna say copying, but they were basically borrowing some ideas from Japan and then localize them in local markets. Even today, many companies pride themselves of being able to make something suitable for Japanese market, and then they can translate that to other markets. Now, Japan being such an advanced market for gaming and such a highly competitive market, because the payouts are big if you can make game suitable for Japan, is one of the very interesting things. And being there on the ground with people and talking with Japanese companies that did it successfully, good Japanese designers and people who really get it, it's extremely valuable. I would definitely advise everybody to study a little more Japan and how the games actually work in Japan, how are new trends set in Japan for the entire gaming industry. Japan is very big on Nintendo Switch. Japan is very big on mobile games. And I personally think that if you are thinking about designing the game, start from the idea, could it be successful in Japan? And if not, or it's too far from you to design a game right now that can be successful in Japan, think about what games would you like to see kind of translated from Japanese market to some other market that you want to do a game. And the second part, there's an extremely good case of the company that did very well, and I think I'm gonna play a video somewhere here. So the company name is Six Waves. It comes from China, and the story goes like a year old story, something like that. The company had a game, and they couldn't make it run in China because the market is too crowded. They don't have big enough budget. They were running out of investment money, there's no option for them to get another round of funding. And with the last marketing money they had, they have decided to publish the game outside of China. And they said, go everywhere, don't go Japan, don't go Korea, try Europe, try US. And just try to publish your game and see what happens. And the marketing guy, the marketing manager was just following the orders. And by some reason, he didn't check out the Japan checkbox when he was running ads, I think on Facebook or Twitter, one of those two platforms. And they end up spending maybe $100 or $200 running the ads within that campaign. And what they have discovered, that they were able with their game to acquire more users from Japan than everything else combined. And once they discovered this, probably weeks later, they have shifted all the marketing to Japan. And flash forward a year now, the company is, I don't know, somewhere around 10 or between 10 and $50 million revenue from Japanese market. And their game is now wildly successful. They now have opened another office in Japan. I don't know, they have went fully to Japan. And the trick here is that sometimes the luck is a huge factor. But what you can learn from this, the company is called Six Waves. I'm going to link it somewhere if you want to go and take a look at the game and things like that. But what you can learn from this is that if you try these big markets first, like a Japan, you will be able to get such a good feedback and you can improve upon on your game. Now, there are a couple of more companies that did this similarly, and if you are interested, I'm going to make a full video in depth talking about this. But what you can see from the culture in Japan, it's completely different culture. The Japanese player is so open to giving a feedback, and they all like to share. So if you if you have made your game shareable, invitable for the player, if you have worked on that system that can bring new players easily, or you have incentivized players to invite other players, you have made yourself Japanese ready for market. So if your game is appealing to the Japanese player, they are going to be inviting everybody to try the game. They're going to be a messenger of your game. That's very, very important on Japanese market. The second part on the cultural side is that Japanese, even in the business, they're very respectful of one another, and they like to keep things very professional. So unlike some other markets where you can go really combo, okay, with all different kind of ways, in Japan, that you need to have a very, very important strategy, and you have to follow certain patterns what the customer and the player expects of your game. So customer support has to be there. You need to have a couple of Japanese people on your team who can help you communicate and broadcast that message. There are a couple of companies that do influencer marketing in Japan that are really valuable. You need to know them, and you need to know how to work with those influencers so they can really broadcast your message. And you have to be open to accept their idea how to make your marketing Japanese friendly. So another thing that I was blown is, I knew this, but just being there, it kind of feels really differently. Japanese people do not appreciate applauding to anything. They simply think that applauding somebody after their performance is insulting. And that's normal, that's a different culture, right? They don't favoritize handshake, they favoritize small bow when you're meeting somebody. So you need to be aware of these cultural differences. And if you are interested in going to Japan, you have to kind of at least study them, understand them, and accept them, that that's how the entire country works. They don't applaud, they have one special thing. I'm gonna play a video right here.
はい、というわけで早速プレゼンターを紹介しましょう。さあ、最初の作品は紹介します。アップライト。
And now when you see how they do these things, you have to really be open-minded to understand it, and just simply use all these things that you learn and apply them to your product and apply them to your marketing so your game can really be successful in Japan. I have probably a lot of things that I want to share with you from this trip, but I think that if you're building a game that's going to Japan, please reach out and I'm happy to share more, or talk to you more about the ideas, how you can adjust and improve your game to fit the Japanese market. If you need any service in Japan, or you need to find somebody, or you need something happening in Japan, please reach out and I'm more than happy to introduce you to some of my friends who can really help you doing business in Japan. Take care guys, and see you in the next show.